Now we request Mr. Rishab Jain and Yash Jain to give a small demonstration about one of their products that has been displayed.
Good evening. So before we start, I would just like to show you a small clip about our product. So we represent Smixin, which is actually a Swiss innovation. So just your eyes here, so just a second. Sorry, a little technical issue.
This is what you need with this mixing and washing system. Not more, not less. This is this mixing and washing. It's very simple. You trigger the machine with your hands, you get an active foam following to the rinsing water and the paper.
Is it audible? So basically, this is the Smixin, the smart hand washing system. So basically, this system is a regular conventional tap uses around 1 to 1.2 liters of water. But in this, you will only use half a glass, that is 100 ml of water per hand wash. So the amount of water which you save in this particular innovation is almost 90%. So basically, this is an all-in-one unit where you have first your soap dispensing, then you have the water dispensing, and then you have the tissue dispensing. In one of our models, you have tissue dispensing. And the basically, the main motive of this company is to save almost 10 billion liters of water by 2021. So if you see, we have three models in this. One is the combi unit, which is basically you have a full standing unit. We have three models in those. We have a countertop model. We have a wall mount model, also a freestanding model. Now, the best part about this is, first you can set the parameters of soap, water, paper, consumption, which you require as per your needs. Now, in a regular standard, if you want to have a clean hand wash, all you need is a 0.5 ml of soap, 100 ml of water, and one tissue paper. Now, in this machine, you save all of these because usually when you go visit washrooms, you see people pull a lot of tissues. Accidentally, sometimes 2-3 tissues come out. But in this, you can set one length as per your need. Only that length will be dispensed. Now, if anyone wants to get one more tissue, he has to repeat the whole cycle. So basically, you are creating a habit in people to save those resources and also utilize it efficiently. So in the whole model, you also have a LED screen, a 10-inch LED screen, where you can have your 10 to 12 videos played. You can have your ad promotions, your HR values, your promotions happening in the corporates or in the malls or in the airports, which will also generate revenue for you and also promote your ideologies to your employees, your customers, or etc. Also, the best part about this machine is that it is remote controlled. So any resource which is going low in the washroom, your person doesn't have to regularly go check every 2 hours if the resources are low. Everything can be monitored from a central management space, where he can see the resources if they are low, if the soap level is low, if the paper is low. So it alerts at the system and also at the central space that the resources are low. So it can immediately, as soon as the alert comes, the person can go and replace the used ones with the fresh ones. So again, all the data, the statistics about how much soap has been used, how much paper has been used, how many people have washed their hands, all the data can be accumulated at the center space. Because today, even data generation is also one of our costs which we occur, which is also taken care of in this machine. Now, this is the whole loaded machine. Now, we have one more, which is for your regular sinks, which for your retrofit sinks. That is the compact. Now, the compact has the same functionality of the soap and the water. So first, it dispenses the soap. Then it dispenses the water. But it doesn't have the tissue dispensing or the screen, but also can be remote controlled from a central location. And when I say remote control, the number of units when you install, if you install 100 units all over the globe, you can control or you can monitor all the 100 units from one central location. So you can have all the data which is required by you of the consumption, the number of people washing, the resources, so you can plan it out in the future also, the consumption of how much you need to purchase or how much you need to go ahead with. Now, this is the countertop model, as I showed you, and that's the wall mount model. Now, as I told you, it has an automatic dispenser. Now, there are different options where you can have a manual dispenser, or you can, if you can, you can also have without screen if you require. Now, also has an infrared sensor, so there are two sensors in the machine. One is the body sensor, which is right in front, and one is the hand sensor. So, as soon as you step ahead of the machine, it senses your body, and then when you put your hand in, it senses your hands. So, it's a very friendly machine, which invites you to have a very nice, efficient, hygiene hand wash. So, this is the soap pouch which comes with the machine. So, the best part about this machine and the soap pouch is, people don't have to cut soap pouches or fill it in. And also, today, people move around the washroom to take soap. They touch different places. This whole machine is sensor-based, so it is maximally hygienic. Also, this one soap pouch, which is 1.5 liter, will give you 3,000 hand washes. So you set a parameter of 0.5, which will give you a 3,000 hand wash, one pouch. Also, next. Currently, the soap pouch we have only in one flavor, that is the cherry blossom, but soon we are going to have different flavors. This is the supervision tool where I told you that you can connect everything to one central location and you can have your statistics, your consumption, your usage frequency, everything can be gathered at one central location. Now, as I told you, the advantages of Smixin is that it is touch-free. So where hygiene is a huge factor, this machine is to be placed there. And minimalistic spillage, because when you have one machine having the tissue dispenser, the soap dispenser, the water dispenser in one unit, the person doesn't have to move around to the in the washroom with his wet hands. So the spillage of water which is there around, which has to be cleaned every 2 hours so that there is no accident or anything which happens in the washroom, is minimalized. Then it is fully controlled by you because everything is set as by your requirements. The parameters are set by you from the start point. Efficient soap usage, because people tend to pull out how much soap they require or the tissues. So everything is efficiently put into the machine by yourself in the start itself. Now, also it has a 10 inch and it's a very easy installation. You have to just give it a regular inlet and outlet which you give for your regular taps. And the same thing has to be given it to it. Now, this is one of the operation cost which we had taken out. For a 3,000 hand wash, the soap amount used in Smixin is only 1.5 liter, but in a regular tap, you almost use 12 liters of soap. So the amount of soap which you save is almost 10.5 liters of soap. Also, tissue, because you have a fixed length, so only one tissue per cycle you get, so that's 3,000 tissues for 3,000 hand washes, where average people pull two tissues out, that is almost 7,500 to 2.5% of tissue. Also, the soap consumption, the paper consumption, and the this is water. The water consumption in a regular hand wash, as I told you, is 1 to 1.2 liters. In this, you have only 0.1 liter of water. So the amount of water also you save in 3,000 hand washes is almost 5,040 liters of water. Now, this is a few applications which are currently happening with Smixin. So that's the KFC and different restaurants and different office buildings. This is the compact unit. So compact is basically for your retrofit sinks, and the countertop is for your new buildings. So you also save a lot of capex cost because you have to have a separate soap dispenser, paper dispenser. You have to have a 2 feet by 2 feet marble slabs for your sinks. But in this is only 1.5 feet by 1.5 feet, which can be wall mounted even outside the washroom. So you're also decreasing your capex cost by almost 40% and also increasing, basically you're making your washroom look even bigger and also efficiently used. This is basically Smixin around the world. So we are, one fact about which we read was basically there's a lady called Myriam Sidibel, who's a doctorate in hand washing with soap. She had said that 4 out of 5 people around the globe don't wash their hands when they move out of the washroom. which is actually surveyed and also proven that 4 people out of 5 don't wash their hands when they move out of the washroom. So the hygiene factor where we see here is taken care in Smixon because they have to wash. It creates a habit. As I said, it creates a habit of them to wash their hands with soap, which kills all the germs and the diseases which are caused due to hand wash. Thank you. Thank you so much. So it runs on power. So power, the maximum power used in this is 20 watts in the fully loaded machine, which has a screen and automatic dispenser. But the minimum power use is 8 watts. Yes, in cases.
Power failures will have to give a battery backup.
As the battery backup will move there.
No, is it covered with the raw power or it has inbuilt battery?
No,
raw power. Raw power.
Is there any option you have, inbuilt battery kind of thing?
Right now, we don't have any option.
Okay.
I think it is better, at least you have a separate tissue dispenser. that's the thing. You are opening the C4. Generally, corporates use a C4 tissue. You are basically opening that tissue and giving it a roll form so that they optimize the use of tissue. That is the way you are reducing the consumption. If you see a normal hand wash, after a normal hand wash, a 10-inch length, which is a general length of a C4 tissue, is good enough for you to dry your hands. But still, we have a habit of putting 2-3 tissues on.
That's good.
The tissues will not be acceptable. People, they have to put it, they have to get some force for you. That is the human tendency.
That is why you have to
do there will be a lot of complaints. That's what I was saying.
Now that is what you are trying to control and make them aware of what you are trying to do and what we should be doing.
What more difference? What
I think that awareness video, you can play it on the 10-inch display. I would put it that way. I think sophistication is coming all
across. At the end of the day, optimization is the key, water or energy. I think this solution is something which we could really appreciate and we can test as well. Thank you, Mr. Rishab Jain and Yash Jain, for presenting this product. And I would now request Nagaraj, sir, to give us the vote of thanks.
So good evening. My name is Nagaraj, and Murugesan has mandated me to, speak here. And again, it's our duty to thank the speakers. So first of all, Mohan, thanks for the wonderful, the discussions on the earthing. And then this is one thing that is extremely basic, and then we all forget earthing. So it was very thoughtful and insightful, and then we learned the many types of earthing. And then I don't know in how many places we do the mat earthing for the buildings. I really do not know how many places, but again, if we start doing it, it can really add a lot of safety features. And then more important than the equipments is the safety of people, and safety of people is of paramount importance. So I think this is something we should start, inculcating. So thanks, Mohan, for the, amazing discussions. Then again, thanks, Mr. Sridharan of the Fluke. Then again, what I saw here is that there is no difference between a human body and a machine or an equipment. And whatever, the preventive maintenance equipments Mr. Sridharan spoke of, I actually can correlate many of those things to the human body. For example, if we are feverish, again, I can correlate the temperature there to an equipment, and then that is certainly a sign of sickness for us. Or, in fact, for the, we use moisture level meters, especially on the walls, just again to see the temperature differential between the external surface and the internal surface, especially in the plumbing systems, and that can really show the likely leakage that can happen at a future date. So that's again, it's a very insightful discussion again by the Fluke. And last but not the least, our good friends Yash and team have spoken about the sustainability measures. And then one thing that I can talk about them is they need to make a compelling proposition to reduce the costs. This is something very important, even though it could be for the refurbishments, but still they need to make a compelling case for facilities management professionals here to try them. So with this, I thank each and everyone for attending this. So before concluding this, I request you all to download the TecKXpert app from the Google Play Store. So this is something we all should do. Okay, thanks, Mr. Murugesan, again, for making me come here and speak. So again, have a nice networking and dinner. Good night.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. And before closing, I would like to thank our title sponsors, Fluke, today. So do visit visit the counter there and experience all the products as well. And also our associate sponsors, Vaibhav Enterprises, very innovative solutions. And again, sir, help me to remind you all to download the app. So the feedback that you're filling in can be automatically done through the app. So there are many benefits once you download the app and test it and start using it. So kindly download the app. This is the QR code. You can scan it and download. It's available for Android, and it is going to come for Apple users as well. So please download the app and make sure that is a single point of communication tool for you than the WhatsApp, because eventually the app would be the single source of communication.